everyone, it's Lisa. Happy Friday. I hope that you have had a wonderful week. We've had a weird week. Today I had Will, matter of fact, I need to go get his book bag out of the car. I had the car all loaded up and his teacher texted me and said that they thought they had a school shooter at the school. So you can imagine how my morning has been. Then my sister-in-law texted me, then my brother, my friend Mary in West Virginia. And so we have been we stayed home, of course, and now we're hearing that it may have been an air conditioned problem that they thought was gunshot or something. It wasn't at his school, it was at the high school, which is on like the same campus. But the sad thing is, it was already, you know, time for some kids to, you know, almost be there. And so they were having to keep the kids in the buses across the street in a parking lot. It's just bad. But I'm going to, seems like something is happening every day. So I'm just gonna persevere and go ahead and show you some of my favorite things that I've gotten this week and some things I think you might like. And so we'll start right off with some Sephora. I bought the Charlotte Tilbury Flawless Filter in number 4. Normally I get number 3. And I got number 4, and it looks like it is a beautiful color. I have it on today, matter of fact. I did kind of a Victoria's Secret inspired look. I have that same quad that, I don't know if it's the same one that she's using. She kept saying it was the Exaggerize palette, bigger, brighter eyes. Maybe it's the other one. Anyway, I use this palette, which is Exaggerize. And so this is the look I did today, and that's what I used. Something I used on this look that I just got, I think yesterday, is the Smith 220 brush. And I cannot remember who I saw use this. I can't remember. I want to give whoever it was credit because this is a fabulous little unique brush. And what they used it for, could it have been Tati? I don't know. But what they used it for is like when you put your crease color, and you know how sometimes it'll be a little bit too harsh, like right there, and then when you go to blend it out, it ends up blending up too much or blending out too much. This brush is good for blending right at that line that you are trying to blend out, and it's real soft, and it's kind of it's a little bit thicker than you would think. It's not like a thin, it's just a real interesting brush. So I used that today and I loved it. Another thing I used today and I loved, I don't have any like contour or bronzer or anything like that on. I just have this, which is the Laura Mercier Translucent Loose Powder Glow in Medium Deep. And boy, is it pigmented. Hey, Bridgie. Bridgie does have a UTI. The vet just called me this morning and I'm getting ready to go pick up her medicine. You choking? Do you need to go outside? Anyway, I did half of the little sticker thing, and then I just used it on, oh, I can't even remember what brush it was. Seems like it might have been that same Sedona Lace brush. So let me go take her out real quick. Okay, I'm just gonna leave her out there. She's walking around the backyard. Anyway, so love this powder. I think it did a beautiful job. I brought it in a little too close, but the Victoria's Secret look is kind of like that anyway, so I didn't worry about it, but next time I might watch it. I might use a smaller brush. So those are two good things I got this week. Too Faced sent me a brand new tube of Better Than Sex mascara, a treat for you and your lashes. So that will be nice to try again. I've used it before, and mascara is one of those things. I go from one to the other of which ones I like the most, but I do know that I like that one because it does give volume. Okay, I finally got another bottle of the Lawless foundation, and this is in the shade Mojave. It's what I have on today, and I think it's going to be the perfect shade. You have to let me know if it looks better than the golden and the, I can't remember the other shade I got, but the only thing is I had a hard time getting it to pump out, and then when it did, it was really, really thick. I don't know if maybe in shipping it got really cold or what. I know that it's all natural, so it might not have whatever ingredients would keep it. You know what I mean? So I'm just gonna see how it goes. I don't wanna return it because I can't exchange it here. I bought a backup of the Lancome Camilla Coelho Parisian Nude. I love this. This with Ideal is my favorite. Really like that a lot. Okay, these I bought, can't remember, seems like it might have been like Samaj, I think, Sam, that used these, but they're Juno and Company microfiber velvet sponges. And I got like a little set that has the two different shapes, but I just got these yesterday, so I'll have to let you know how they go. Okay, let's get into like some favorites. I know one of my big favorites I got this week, Brooke and I went to Sephora, and I actually, it was the last day of the like VIB Rouge sale, and we got this, which is the Buxom. I don't know if we got this at Sephora or at Ulta. We might have gotten this at Ulta because we went both places in one day, but it's the Party All Night Buxom 12-piece midi lip plumpers plus eye veil. Oh, I didn't even see that little thing in there. Okay, but this is the best little set. I mean, we have been using it. I've been keeping it out here just to show you, but it has four of these lip liners, and I mean all the good ones. Dolly Danger, I think this is, and I love it. The names are hard to read on here. I believe this is, no, this is Scandalous. And then, now that I know where to look, Undercover. I'm telling you, all the ones that are the best ones. Dolly Danger, and then a red one. I haven't used this one yet. What is your name? Infrared. And then it has these like sparkly Buxom glosses, and then these are the full-on lip colors, and it has like Mudslide, Hot Toddy, Mudslide, just beautiful. So that is definitely worth it and would be a really good gift for someone. Okay, I got the brush that Tammy used when she did my contour that day. She touched up my contour when I was at her house in Florida, and she used this. It's the Sigma Power Sweep F06, and I'll be honest, I haven't used it yet because I've had it out here to show you, but it's a really neat brush. I think it would be good for lots of different things. Sweeping off powder if you bake, but I'm probably going to use it. Matter of fact, I might have to use it with that Laura Mercier powder. I don't think so. I think I can use something bigger than this. I probably maybe will use a tapered powder brush next time. So anyway, loving that. So I got some good brushes and stuff this week. One of the biggest, best things I got, let me get up and get it, hold on. Okay, I was strolling through Instagram one day, and one of the girls that lives here in town that has a hair salon was doing her hair, and it was about the same length as mine, and she was using this curling iron, which is the GHD Curve Iron, Classic Curl, Long Lasting Curls. And there was a special. If you ordered this curling iron, which, oh my goodness, I got this yesterday and I had to use it last night. I just brushed out the fronts of my hair and it is so smooth. And even this is like, I don't know how to explain how smooth this is. And it doesn't have like temperature control, but it doesn't go any higher. It heats up in I think 25 seconds. And optimum styling temperature of 365. Heat up time, 25 seconds. Ultrazone technology, 2-year guarantee, universal voltage. So it heats up evenly. And if you ordered it now, they with it came a little GHD travel hair dryer. And that is such a plus for me because I always have to take my hair dryer, and this will be great. I can't use the ones in the hotel, so this one should be perfect. So I thought that was such a good deal. And I love this. I've loved everything I've ever gotten from GHD. So excited about that. When I used it last night, it was just perfect. Okay, I think what I'm going to do is, YSL sent me their, oh my goodness, their gorgeous Christmas collection of lipsticks. But I think I might save this and do a separate video with these and like try some of them on. I think that would be better and show them off a little bit better. But I went to H&M I think it was last weekend, I was already out and the kids and John were meeting me at the Burger at Five Guys, and I had just enough time to stop in somewhere, so I stopped in H&M. And most everything I got is stuff for winter time, and it's still hot here. I don't know how, let me see what the temperature is right now. Okay, I had to say bye to Brooke. She's going to my mom. She's been helping my mom clean. Okay, it's 61 out there now, and looks like it's going to get to 72, 73. So we just haven't had any good cool weather yet, but I did get some good sweaters. I've been wanting some of those big chunky sweaters to like wear over my slip dresses, just different things like that. So I'm going to get up, show you my outfit of the day, and then we'll do that stuff that I got from H&M. I'll be right back. Okay, so for my outfit today, I have on just a big white shirt. I was looking for one last week, and just to throw on with anything, I just love how a big, like the look of a big men's shirt, and so that's what this is. It's from Gap. It's an extra large men's shirt, and I believe it was on sale. And then my leggings are something different. My leggings are something that John bought me, and these are Tommy Copper. I don't know if you've ever seen that advertisement of the Tommy Copper, supposed to be good for your muscles and all this stuff. And so he ordered him a shirt, and then I got the leggings, and they're real high waist, and I loved them, and they feel so good, and I love the way they look. They're kind of like the ones that have kind of like a sheen. And so love these. And then I've got on the Stuart Weitzman sock booties that I got from the Nordstrom sale. It's the first time I've worn them. Very comfortable. I love Stuart Weitzman boots. And matter of fact, my purse is in the car while we were getting ready to leave earlier this morning. So this is my casual outfit of the day. I bought this little hat. It's kind of like, you guys know how I love like that turban look. And this little hat has kind of got that look. Got the little turban part. I don't know if you remember Sarah Jessica Parker in Sex and the City wore these. So I got that for Brooke and I for the winter time. I got this shirt that I think is so pretty. I think that is going to look so good, like with black pants or even leggings with a, you know, leather moto or something over it. And I believe they might have had this in white. I just love, this is like one of my favorite colors, where it's that peachy rose kind of color, a tawny rose. And you know, none of this was very expensive. This was $19.99. Okay, this is one of my favorites. It's a big sweater. This one was $34.99 and it's a large. And this is, again, see, I could put this like over this shirt. And just love it. Kind of, it's soft. I will not get any of those sweaters that feel cheap or scratchy or hot. This one just feels good. And then this is my favorite. I saw this right when I walked in. And see, like this with over a shirt, or even this over like my black Victoria's Secret slip dress. I think it's going to be so pretty, and I love that like cowl neck. Sorry, the trash man is going by. And so I love that. I hope it's still available. It was last weekend. This was only $24.99, and I believe it might have come in like a mustard color too. Okay, so I guess that's it for the day. I have on these earrings that I bought from the Nordstrom sale. I really got some good stuff. I'm glad. And they're like Naudry brand, and I just thought that would be good with like nothing else, and the shirt. And my nail polish is a new nail polish from Chanel. It's the Velvet nail color in number 638 Profondeur. I'll put it down below. And I'm sure I probably got something else here that I missed, but we will catch up on that next time. And oh gosh, thank you for my good response on my video yesterday. And thank you guys for so many of you that have subscribed to Brooke. If you don't follow me on Instagram, my daughter Brooke has started a YouTube channel, and she's doing so good. And she just really has a great, her makeup is gorgeous. Her style is, sometimes when she comes out of her room, I'm like, how did she even think of putting that together? Just great. Everywhere we go, she gets compliments on her makeup and her outfits and everything. And we have a lot of fun doing stuff like that. And so I'll put her link. My goodness. I don't know what's... Oh, helicopter. I bet that's from all the stuff going on at the school this morning. So sad. It's like, what is going on in this world? It's very scary. I'm trying not to let it affect me. But anyway, so have a wonderful weekend. All the links and stuff down below, and I will see you real soon. Bye-bye.